Hey, good morning, everyone. How are you doing? Hope you're having a good day in spite of all of the COVID-19 stuff. Hope your families and yourselves are doing well. This is Pastor Peter here. I wanted to talk today about the topic of gay marriage. Now, I know that this has been talked about over and over again, but I want to specifically address the topic of why it is that so many conservative Christians still do not agree with gay marriage and still do not find gay marriage to be biblical. And a lot of people who are skeptics of Christianity wonder this. A lot of people who are also Christian, who are more on the socially liberal scale, wonder this as well. And here's the answer. When you read through the Old Testament, it's obviously against homosexuality as a lifestyle. When you read through the New Testament, you don't see a change. It's obviously still against homosexuality as a lifestyle. It calls homosexuality, the act of sex between people of the same sex, as something that is detestable. The King James Version even calls it an abomination. Now, when you look at that and you go from Genesis all the way to Revelation and you see something similar, then that means that's probably something that God has instituted whether it is a good thing. If God is for it, then definitely we should be for it. If it is something that is against it, from all of Scripture, from Genesis all the way to Revelations, then that means that God would probably want us to be against it. And so this is why people who are conservative Christians, you'll find it really hard to budge them on this subject of gay marriage, because from the conservative Christian's point of view, the Bible clearly states that the homosexual lifestyle is a sin, and therefore gay marriage would be a sin. Also, when we are just as surprised, for those of us who really think about the Bible and think about really justifying certain relational or sexual lifestyles from a biblical point of view, why people who want to be progressive about marriage and about relationships would go for gay marriage first. A lot of people who are pro-gay marriage or who are married as gay people will wonder about the history of the Bible and also, for example, Mormonism or certain Christian cults who were for polygamy. And they would be against polygamy and aghast at people who would be for polygamy, but they'd be okay with gay marriage. And for people who are conservative Christians, they would be surprised, because when you look through the Bible, especially in the Old Testament, it seems like there's way more evidence to support polygamy as a legitimate form of marriage rather than gay marriage. And so it seems for the conservative Christian that you'd have a much better chance of legalizing polygamy than you do have a chance of legalizing a gay marriage. And why would you jump to gay marriage first? I mean, if you want to take those progressive steps, shouldn't you first justify polygamy as a form of a marriage and then maybe take the next stepping stone to gay marriage, right? Because the Old Testament, not much the New Testament, but definitely the Old Testament, seems to lean for supporting or at least allowing for polygamy, because the greats were polygamists, right? We had David, he was polygamous, King David. We had King Solomon, he was very, very polygamous. And even from extra-biblical history, when you look outside of the Bible, polygamy was everywhere. It wasn't until Christianity came in that polygamy had a downturn because of the advance of monogamy and the preaching about how the ideal relationship of marriage should be monogamy between man and a woman. And so another reason for why a lot of conservative Christians are still against gay marriage is because of the fact that it's clear from Genesis to Revelation again that marriage is between a man and a woman. Not between a man and a man, not between a woman and a woman. And so when people say, well, isn't marriage just about love? Can't just anyone who love each other join themselves and be together to death do their part? Well, for the Christian who looks at the Bible and takes it seriously, they'll get no, because marriage is between a man and a woman. It's not just about love. There's a certain regulation to what marriage is, and there's a certain regulation to what a family is. And so when people wonder about why a lot of Christians don't allow for gay marriage, they truly love each other. Well, a lot of Christians would say, that's great. If you love each other, fine. You could do what you want with your life, but we can't support marriage because marriage is between a man and also a woman. There's definitions to marriage. Last but not least, a lot of people wonder why people who purport that God is a God of love and grace wouldn't allow gay marriage. And here's the reason why. Because people who take the Bible seriously, especially conservative Christians, they also see God as a God of holiness, meaning that he's not just a God of love and grace where he'll just allow anything. I mean, even the most socially liberal Christian will know that God isn't gracious enough that he's going to say, go ahead and murder people, or God is so gracious that he's going to allow for you to commit adultery whenever you want, or God is so gracious that you can just go and rob banks. God is so gracious that you can just be mean to people. There are certain rules and guidelines that are there because God isn't just a God of grace. He is also a God of holiness. And what holiness means is that there are certain standards of conduct that separate what God wants from the rest of the world. And that's what it means to be holy, right? To have a certain conduct of goodness that separates whatever those conducts are from the rest of the world. And one of those holiness codes or conduct is that marriage is between, again, a man and a woman, husband and wife. And so these are the reasons why you have a whole host of Christians out there, primarily conservative Christians, who are still against gay marriage. And it's going to be very hard for someone to convince them otherwise unless you do a couple of things. First of all, you need to break their confidence in the Bible as at least the reliable Word of God, and at most the inspired Word of God. Because if you could break their confidence in the Bible as something that is authoritative, meaning that it's a reliable manuscript, that people who wrote it actually did write it, and that they were inspired by God to do so, then you just have a man-made document. And if it's a man-made document, then human beings change, right? Human beings' minds change. It's just something that was from their opinion rather than something that was actually from God. The second thing that you're going to need to do is show from culture, okay, not just from the Bible, but from culture back then, that Jewish people and the early Christians were okay with gay marriage. You have to come up with examples where you have people who were great Christian leaders being okay with gay marriage, or great Jewish leaders being okay with gay marriage. And the reason why is because even if you take away the authority and inspiration of God's word and you show that it's not authoritative or that it's not inspired, there's a lot of errors in it to show that it's not inspired and it's not reliable, you still have the problem of, okay, well, this was the Christianity that they created. This was the Judaism that they created. And if I want to be faithful to original Christianity or original Judaism, then even though it may not be the inspired word of God, it's still authoritative in that I can't just make Christianity or Judaism any way I want, because if I do, then it's not really Christianity or Judaism. I just made a new religion. It's some sort of neo-Christianity or neo-Judaism. And so you have to find examples of authentic Christian or Jewish communities which practiced gay marriage back then. And let me tell you, for both of these things, it's going to be very hard for you to do so, because conservative Christians have really good arguments for why they believe that the Bible is reliable and inspired, and also why authentic, genuine, original Christianity and Judaism was pretty much always against gay marriage. So if you wondered why, even though gay marriage is legal now in the United States and in many other countries, that there are still a whole bunch of Christians who still don't believe in it and who don't practice it, these are some of the main reasons why. I hope that has been insightful, and may God bless you.